Have we not start the explanation part?
We had start
the reading and explanation together, sir.
Yeah, how much? That's what I'm asking you.
You present?
Okay.
Sir, I can, I know.
If you fail to say the correct answer, what do I do? Okay. Anyways, this is the Purty and the Lion Cub. Now tell me, how far have we gone here? How much have I explained you?
Sir, as well, but I can. I know. Sir, till then.
Yes, Zohair Abbas, tell me.
The lion cub getting big and now he is not drinking the milk. He eats the special meat.
Very good. Impala meat. So, who wants to read from here?
Mama Zaki Wakil.
Asari Zohair Abbas. Asari Ahmad Fazil.
Mama Zaki Wakil.
Okay, one by one. Yes, Zaki. Start.
For the first time in his life, Bertie was totally happy. The lion cub was all the brothers and sisters he could ever want, and all the friends he could ever need. The two of them would sit side by side on the sofa and watch the great red sun go down over Africa. And Bertie would read him Peter and the Wolf. And at the end, he would always promise him that he would never let him go off to a zoo and leave behind bars like the wolf in the story. And the lion cub would look up a Bertie with his trusting amber eyes.
Okay. Now, students, here it is written that how they used to live together, Bertie and the lion cub. So, Bertie was very happy in his life henceforth, because otherwise he was not having any brother or sister. So, what was the routine otherwise for the Bertie was, father used to go to office, mother used to complete her routine tasks, household work, and Bertie was all alone. He was feeling very lonely, obviously. Now the lion cub was there to accompany him wherever he used to go. So he was very happy and he was having all the brothers and sisters and everything. Whatever dream he was having, he was fulfilling it with the lion cub. The two of them used to sit side by side on the sofa and watch the great sun, red sun, go down over Africa. Means what? This line means to say that from morning to the late evening, from dusk till dawn, they used to sit together on the sofa, do various things, foolish, stupid things, play together, do the meaningful things. Even Bertie used to read the story. Name of the story? Peter and the Wolf. So in this story, Peter at last keeps the wolf in the forest behind the bars, means what? In the cage. And Bertie used to promise to the lion cub that I will not keep you in the jungle or in the cage. I promise you, I will never leave you. As Peter did with the wolf, I will never do with you. This is what Bertie used to promise. And lion cub looked with very innocent, cute face on Bertie, as if lion cub was able to understand everything. Students, my question to you is, will lion understand English?
No.
Okay, one student said no. What is your point of view?
Well, I am also, I was asking to you.
What you're trying to ask me?
That he can, he can.
Lie
sir.
English.
He can know
English.
Lion know English.
Okay, you're trying to ask me that will lion understand English or not? My answer is yes.
No.
Yes.
Sir, if we make bet.
Exactly. That is where my point is. See, even if you keep the pet dog, parrot, cat, whatever you keep as a pet,
sir,
from childhood,
sir,
can I finish my line?
Yes, yes.
Behave yourself. So, when you keep a pet animal, that means what? You bring them to your place right from when they are very little, when they are young, when they are very young. So, when you train them, accordingly they will behave. See, no matter whatever will happen, you will never train, you will never be able to train the dog to speak like a human being. But I have seen the videos in Instagram or somewhere where dogs are able to speak almost same as we do. And moreover, they are very easily trained to understand. When you say sit, they will sit. When you say stand up, they will stand up. When you will say stay over there, they will stop running. So they understand our language if we train them accordingly. So here, Bertie used to read this story every now and then to this lion cub. So at least not whole story, but lion cub was able to understand the feelings Bertie used to share. And see how beautiful the eyes of lion cub is. And I will surely keep this kind of lion cub if I will get as a pet. Yes, now someone was trying to speak something. Please tell me.
Yes, sir. If we say the dog which are staying in the on the road or there which are not a pet roaming in the on the road, we say sit down, they will not sit down. And if we say to our pet dog, then he will do that thing which we say.
So exactly this is what I mean, students. If see, if you people also don't answer me, that means I will even consider you as an animal roaming on the roads. Because generally human beings answer me when I ask some certain questions. So that is the difference between the human being and the animals on the road. Even the dog will understand our language if they are pet. Then why can't we human beings try to understand and follow the instruction? Now if I ask you the question, yes or no, student, only three students will answer yes, yes, yes. Rest
yes.
of them are staying on the street, on the road or what? Then I will consider them as a street animal.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
It is very, very general, no?
Yes.
See, say for an example, if you are teaching, just example, you are a teacher, and if no one will answer you, how will you feel? Oh, I'm teaching to the street animals or what? They will just eat whatever we throw on their mouth and they will go away. So if you don't want to behave like that, then behave like a human being, disciplined human being. Whenever you need, you can ask me the question 10 times. At least when sir is asking the question, if you know the answer, you should say, yes, sir, I know the answer. I will share the answer. If you do not know, you should say, sorry, sir, I don't know. But if you don't answer at all, that means you are a street animal, for sure. Am I right or wrong?
Yes. Right, sir.
Right.
Right. Right. Right.
Okay. Who will read from here now?
Sir, can I read Vindhyasan?
Yes, Vindhyasan.
Ganesari Ahmad Khazib.
Why don't you give him a name? His mother asked one day.
Means what, Vindhyasan? These two lines means what? Can you explain?
But his mother said that why you didn't decide his name. You are saying he's Lion Cub. Why you didn't decide his name?
Yes. So Bertie's mother says that you should give him name. From so many months he is with us, give him one beautiful name. Okay, before going any further, mute your mic. Students, I'd like to write here the name of the lion cub, but suggestion should be yours. That means, if you have the lion at your house, what name you will give? Come on, one by one. Come on, Muhammad, give me the name. Yes, Vakil Zaki.
Tommy.
Okay. Anyone else? Boys. Come on, fast. Decide the good name.
Sir, Tiny Land Boy.
One by one.
Sir, I can. Sir, I can.
One by one. Come on. One by one. Who will say first?
No, Tiny Lion Boy.
Who will say?
Really, guys.
Someone was speaking first. Tiny something.
Sorry. I'm not sure. I said that Tiny Lion Boy.
Tiny? Tiny lion. Okay. Yes, Ali Ghazi.
Tommy.
Tommy is already said.
Sir, I think
another name. See, you have to give the name to lion, so think accordingly.
Sir, Fuko.
Huh?
Fuko.
Spelling?
F-U-K-O, Fuko.
Fuko. Gujarati?
No. It is English.
Yes, Zaki.
Pluto.
Yes, anyone else?
Sir,
Pluto.
Now, one by one, dear. I cannot hear the other students.
Pluto.
Sir, I am safe.
Yes, beta.
I say na.
Sir, Sweetie.
Yeah. Huh?
Sweetie.
Okay. As you
sir,
say.
I say.
Wait, Ali Ghazi, I'm going to talk to your brother, huh? That your brother is giving the name to Lion Sweetie.
Sir, what?
This is Lion Cub male, not female.
Sir, I have no name.
Sir, I have no name.
No, I have written now, Sweetie. You said Sweetie.
Sir, this is him.
No, I will sir, I not hear. Name. Yes, beta.
Pluto.
Can I? Yes,
if you all want to speak together, I will stop this.
Sir, I say E.T.
Mute my dad, everyone.
Raise your hand in the group. I will see.
Sir, E.T.
Can you mute your mic, beta? Very good. Yes, Ali Asgar.
Sir, Muko.
What's spelling? Spelling?
K-O.
Yes.
M-U-K-O. Okay, Muko. Then you can get in the group.
Kyoto.
Yes, Madhya sir.
Sir Jerry.
Sir Jerry. Sir is not Jerry. Yes, Zaki.
Sir Shenu.
Jonty.
Shenu.
Zaki. Yes, Zaki.
Sheru.
Sheru. This is my favorite name. Sheru. So I will keep this. Sheru. Okay. Now onwards, we will refer to this as a Sheru lesson. So, but anyways, Bertie is not giving the name. Here, Bertie says that because he doesn't need one, replied Bertie. He is a lion, not a person. Lion don't need names. This is what Bertie thinks, that lion don't need the name. So I will not give him the name. This is what Bertie is saying. But we will keep the name Sheru. Bertie and the Sheru. Who will read from here? Okay, Zohair Abbas.
Yes, sir. Bertie's mother was always wonderfully patient with the lion. Made how many... So what is this?
Where?
Question.
You did not read this.
No matter how much mess he made, how many cushions he pounced on and ripped apart, no matter how much crockery he smashed, none of it.
Bertie's mother was always wonderfully patient with lion. That means Bertie's mother never used to become angry on the lion because lion cub was so much dear to her. No matter how much mess he made, how many cushions he pounced on and ripped apart, no matter how much crockery he smashed. That means he used to tear the curtains, used to tear the sofa covers, he used to smash the vegetables, all the other grocery items. Mute your mic, no? When I'm speaking, beta. Don't behave like idiots. Or if you are, don't prove you are. So he used to smash the vegetables and other grocery items in the kitchen. Then he used to tear the sofa cover and curtains and everything. But still, Bertie's mother never used to become angry on him. Because for Bertie's mother, Bertie and the lion cub both were equally the children. Both were equally dear to her. Okay. None of it seemed to upset her, and strangely, she was hardly ever ill these days. Now what happened? As soon as the lion cub entered in their lives, Bertie's mother, since then, never became ill. Never became ill means what? Never got the fever or anything, headache or this ache or that ache. She was always happy. There was a spring to her step, and her laughter pealed around the house. That means Bertie's mother was very happy henceforth. She was having the spring means what? She was not jumping. She was every time going here and there, playing with Bertie, playing with the lion cub, cooking the food. She never became tired. That is what this line means. His father was less happy about it. Lions, he would mutter on, should never live in the houses. You should keep him outside in the compound. So father was never happy so much. Father always used to do his work and speak that you should keep this lion out of the house. Don't keep it inside the house, this and that. You know, this is the normal habit. So, but they never did. Means Bertie's mother and Bertie never used to keep the lion outside the house. For both mother and son, the lion had brought the new life to their days. Life and laughter. So, for both Bertie and Bertie's mother, they were enjoying something new. They were enjoying the new life. They were very much ecstatic, very, very happy from within. So they were living happily ever after with the lion cub as a family member. Okay. Any doubts, students? Please ask me.
No, sir.
No doubt.
Are you sure? See, again, the others are a roadside animal. Those who answered, they are human beings.
No doubt, sir.
No doubt, sir.
Okay. Then this was the lesson. Where? Now, who can give me the moral of the story? Come on. What thing you can learn from this story? What is the moral of the story? Come on.
Sir, we have to be an animal lover.
Okay. One moral. Then, see, once if you get the chance, you can mute your mic. Yes, Ali Ghazi.
Save the animal and help him.
Very good. Second moral. What else? Then I will give you a good moral. But first I need from your side. Come on. I want to see that who will give me the moral which I want to give. No one? Okay.
If anyone wanted help, we have to help them.
Okay. Anything else? Anyone? Okay. Can I give the moral?
Yes, of course.
Yes.
First, let me ask you one question. Yeah. Have you seen the lion playing with the human beings in Dubai or anywhere in the videos?
Yes, sir. Yes. Two lions are sitting on the Lamborghini. I have seen.
Lamborghini Terrace.
Okay. I will show you the videos tomorrow in which lion is playing with human being very actively. Okay.
Sir, I have.
What?
Video I have.
Oh, I thought you have lion. That is why I said, what? You have lion? You did not say. But you all have the lion, no? Rohan sir is there. What do you think, students?
Yes, sir.
Who is laughing at me?
Go ahead.
No, sir, my mic is muted. Ali Garvi is laughing.
No. You were laughing. You think that your mic is mute, but it is not mute. Jokes apart. See, students, say for an example, if you are going on the street, sometimes if someone is riding the bike or the car too fast, dogs will run after them. Yes or no? Have you seen that scene?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Many times.
So yes, many a times. Not few times. Many times you might have seen. And if the dogs are sleeping, you just crash your leg with the road so that they run after you. That is the way how you are training them to become bad. They actually are not bad at all. See, why the dogs run after the vehicle? Because they have met an incident. Not all the dogs run every time. So you have to observe. Either that dog has met any accident with a car, or their puppies, you know, dogs gives puppies as the young ones. Either they are killed under the car or under the truck. That is why they are running after every vehicle, because their mind has that negative impact of the vehicle. That if you ride the vehicle very fast, their children will be killed. You will say that, oh sir, why should we care about the street dog? Then my question to you is, will you give the house to every street dog? At least if you cannot give the house, why do you kill them? Am I right or wrong, students? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If you cannot give the house to the street dogs, why do you kill them? If you ride the car or the bike slowly, and if their lives are saved, will you not save their life by just, decreasing your speed of the vehicle? Very easy for us, no? We have to just decrease the speed. Cannot we do that for the animals, yes or no?
Yes.
See, by riding the bicycle, nothing will happen. Even if you will ride the bicycle on the dog. Yes, it will hurt them. They will not be killed. But I'm talking about especially motorcycle or car, buses, trucks. Yes. So these are the vehicles because of which many animals are killed on the road, literally. That is why dogs are running after the fast vehicles, swiftly going vehicles. And you might have noticed, students, that if they are running after you, if you slow down the vehicle, they will stop running. Have you seen that?
Yes, sir.
What, sir?
If the dogs are running behind your vehicle, if you slow down the vehicle, they will stop running. Have you observed that?
Yes, sir.
Why? Because they think that, okay, human beings have slowed down the vehicle, now no one will be killed. That is why. So this is only the reason why they run after the vehicles. You need to understand their mind rather than throwing the stones on their faces. By throwing the stone, again, you are making them more negative. They are already negative. Same as like, see, if Zaki, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Zaki, do you remember once in my class, you did not bring the ID card and I made you cry, if you remember.
Yes, sir.
So that is just example I'm giving you. I hope you don't mind. So students, he forgot the ID card. Now, I was having two options. So I just tried one experiment. I scolded him and he cried. Why? Now he cried. That does not mean that he is accepting the mistake. That means he is becoming negative for Rohan, sir. But if the same time, if I say, no problem, dear, But yes, if tomorrow if you forget ID card, I will send you back home. Then he could have understood his mistake and he could have taken this positively. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now that is, different. Yeah, now that is different thing that if you do the mistake three times, that is not mistake. That is intentionally done the thing. At that time, if he scold you, that is different thing. So everything is good at a certain limit. So moral of this story is, if you give the respect to the animals at the equal level, you will get the respect in back. That does not mean I'm telling you that go to Gir forest and pamper the lion. Then don't say that Rohan sir has told us to give the respect. That is different matter. Because those animals are growing in such environment.